Right now, of course, it's time for some Survivor action.
Dit is korrek, Katlego. Nou, dinge raak wit warm in hierdie reeks van Survivor Tocantins. En gisterand was weer eens 'n opwindende episode. En natuurlik terug saam met ons vanoggend is Tashi Tagg van TVSA en ook Boniswa, sy is 'n TVSA blogger en ook 'n Survivor aanhanger om gesels oor gisterand se episode en ook 'n bietjie ekstra info wat jy dalk nie geweet het nie. Maar eers, kom ons kyk hierna.
Previously on Survivor.
I want you to think about the alliance of Stephen and JT.
I have the power alliance, commanding my officers like I was born to do, hence my name, the Dragon Slayer. Sears won tonight, no brainer.
You're going to be the next to go, but you're not going to be able to change that.
I'm trying to explain my side so it doesn't look like I was the mastermind.
I don't think you were the mastermind. I don't think you're smart enough for it.
Can she save herself?
Given another chance, I would prove I am a loyal person.
Am I going to give you a second chance? Probably not.
There's a large part of me that prays for a miracle.
I think we might just take out Tyson. We might not get another chance.
If we don't take out Tyson now, we can go on a run.
Ninth person voted out the second member of our jury. Tyson, another tribal council, another blindside. This is shaping up to be a battle to the end. Seven are left. Who will be voted out next time on Survivor?
So that was last night's exciting episode of Survivor Tocantins. And if you thought you just tuned into Expresso, you are making a massive mistake because this is actually the Tribal Council set. As you can see, we have the authentic furniture, we have skulls, we have everything, even live insects on set. This is how real this gets this morning. Good morning, Tashi Boniswa. How are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
Lovely. So it was indeed a very exciting episode last night. I think we need to start off talking about Coach that lost his dear friend.
Yes, Tyson.
Tyson. Let's talk a bit about the, wow, the Tribal Council last night.
Yeah, well, it was great, hey? It was lovely. I mean, the whole sort of way, the blindsiding of Tyson and the look on Coach's face.
Yeah. I just love the fact that when they sat there before they casted the votes, that Tyson sat there with a big grin on his face. He was so confident that he's not going to go anywhere. Yeah. And then as they called his name one by one, you just saw that smile disappearing.
I know. Yeah. He thought that Sierra was the one. He was so confident that no one is going to vote for him. And he trusted everyone like too much.
He did
because I mean you can't trust anyone on Survivor, but he trusted everyone like too much that they aren't going to vote for him. It's going to be Sierra leaving the show.
It was so unexpected.
As a massive blindside. Are you guys kind of, you know, happy that he left, or would you have rather someone else leave?
Yeah, I think Sierra should have gone because Tyson was one of my favorites.
Really?
He was, because I thought he was the tougher one. I actually thought he was going to win the competition.
Maybe. Okay, but what about his relationship with Coach? Didn't that put you off him a lot?
I know, but the two of them, I know that most of the people don't like the two of them.
Yeah.
But I think since he was the one who was winning the challenges most of the time, the immunities,
yes.
So I thought maybe he might stay in the competition until the end.
And a lot of people have also liked Tyson because of his sense of humor, so I think it was very odd that he hooked up with Coach. I kind of could never quite understand that they seemed so different, you know?
Anyways, Tyson went. It is a game. He's a strong competitor. I think they made the right choice. Mm-hmm. Now, Boniswa, you mentioned that you're not a big fan of Sierra, and Sierra has been taking heat from the rest of the tribe. Why do you think is that? What makes her so not likable?
I think everyone doesn't like Sierra because maybe they don't like her game plan. I'm not really sure why, but I think they don't like her game plan and the way he and the way she comes across to other people. Maybe her personality with other people clashes.
Yeah, it's something that you can't. Like I'm confused as well because if you were there, you would kind of like her.
Mm. Yeah.
But what's interesting is that in post eviction interviews, Tyson was asked about her, and he said that the thing that he didn't like was that she wanted a lot of validation. Like if she did a challenge, she'd want everybody to like go, "Oh, you were so brilliant," and that sort of thing. Which they haven't edited it like that, except last night in that immunity Nancy challenge when she was jumping around.
Then you could kind of see a little bit of bragginess.
But it was heartbreaking to also see that Tyson, when you had that chat with her, saying that, you know, she is the next one to leave for sure, and that he doesn't think that she's clever enough to win this.
That was very harsh. That was so harsh.
Yeah. So, and
in the tribal council, when he told everyone that he likes this and this and not mentioning Sierra and Erin. That was so nasty.
Yeah, he was nasty and saying that he enjoyed watching her cry. That's actually what the episode was called. It's funny when people cry.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
So quickly, let's move on to the reward challenge. Or the immunity challenge, first of all, where they had the choice of either the pizza or to actually play the game.
Yes.
Now, it was quite funny. First of all, let's talk about Tash. She didn't go for the pizza. She played. What do you think? What's your thoughts on that?
I was wondering whether she would, and what it suggests to me is that she doesn't feel totally confident either in her alliance or with her immunity idol, because it's almost like she doesn't see it as her. Stephen went off and had the pizza.
I love Stephen with his big eyes just sitting there shivering with the cold, chowing this pizza. It was brilliant.
Well, I actually thought so while I was watching them, it looked so painful eating that pizza in the cold.
It was so cold. And him telling everyone to vote for Tyson, it was so quick. He was so quick with that idea that we must vote for Tyson because he's the strongest. He might win the competition.
Exactly.
It was a very sudden change.
All I can say is I'm definitely looking forward to next week. It's going to be another exciting one.
Coach is going to leave next.
Exactly.
Yes.
Let's hope that Coach will leave. But guys, thank you, Boniswa. Very nice of you to join us. Tashi, always nice to have
you
here. Like your outfit this morning.
Thank you.
Very velvety. So if you would like to join us right in studio to come chat about Survivor, it is exciting, something fun, you can just check this out and you will know exactly what to do. So go for it.
If you're a Survivor superfan and want to share your thoughts, rants and raves on the new season of the show with us, then this is your invitation to join the TVSA editor, Tashi Tagg, right here on Expresso.
She comes off to me as kind of the...
He's like a geek.
You know you're not going to be the first to go.
Here's what you need to do. Send us a message or video clip telling us why you'd like to be on Expresso. Email it to expresso@expressoshow.com and remember to include your name and contact details. Survivor Tocantins runs from Monday the 27th of June. See Tashi Tagg and our special viewer guest every Tuesday. It might just be you.